Hello, everybody. It is 10:01 p.m. Central Time on Tuesday, August 23rd, 2016. And welcome into the Earthquake 3D live stream. If you're a new viewer, I want to welcome you in. And to my regulars, guys, we've had a pretty tremendous day. And if you haven't already heard, you can go search it on Google or any search engine. Italy has been struck by multiple large earthquakes east-northeast of Rome, happening at a depth from anywhere at about 40 miles all the way up to about 1 mile depth. And as I was getting ready for the stream, multiple other fives and fours started to strike after the original 6.1, 6.2. If you go search the news, you'll see it at a 6.4. That's where it originally started. Now, this is pretty devastating for the country of Italy in the spot that it struck, because there's already been some people that have been injured and reports that some buildings have collapsed. I don't have any fatality reports to report to you yet, but I can tell you guys, this is bad news for Italy. And I would like to point out to everyone here, this is not any kind of self-congratulating at all, but I have to make you aware of this. I'm going to take you over to my YouTube channel. Here's a video I put out 2 days ago on August 21st, and at about 38 minutes and 27 seconds, I begin my European update in the video. I cover every area on the world, so it's a 40-minute long video, but at the end, I cover Europe, and I specifically warned the area east of Rome for possible larger earthquake activity to strike, and I was basing it upon the threes and fours down here to the south, and the twos and ones happening up around Switzerland and South France. The combined total I was looking for was upper four, lower five. So it went a full magnitude above what I was looking for. And this is not good. As I said in this video, which I will put a link to, you guys are welcome to come over to my channel and check it out. But just so that there's no question, you guys can come and review the video. I'm going to drop it into chat right now while I'm talking. And you guys just bookmark that, save it, whatever you need to do, and go back and watch it. They had a two-day warning in this location, and the reason we issued a warning is because it was the middle of the silent zone. All of Italy had gone silent. Take a look at it. You can see it on the screen here in my video from 2 days ago. The silent spot across Italy, and we always look at our fulcrum point, the middle point between the two spots that have moved. And this helps us to determine the spot to watch and usually the magnitude to watch. As I've said in past videos, we don't want to gamble on magnitude. So if we're looking for a larger earthquake to strike, do you want to bet that it's going to be a mid four or a mid five? If it gets into that mid five, low six range, that's enough to collapse buildings, cause major damage in the area. And as the news reports say, this struck in the middle of the night and it was felt all the way as far as Rome, and it caused a major shakeup in the area. The people had a two-day warning. Now, why didn't they get it? Look at the number of views on this video. I know there's more than 12,000 people in Italy that would like to know when a large earthquake is going to strike. Today is the day that science wins over politics and political corruption. Today is the day that earthquake forecasting gets out to the world via you, who's listening now. You have to understand that I've been attacked by professionals across the board for doing earthquake forecasting, which they denied. Now there is no denial. The spot that we named was hit directly, a magnitude above what I was watching for, and people have been killed, most likely, or seriously injured. So how long are we going to let politics in science dictate over what's obvious, which is earthquakes can be forecast down to a region and a time, and I put a two-day warning on it. Today is day two. So, that struck. Big earthquake, South Italy hasn't struck in, well, we haven't seen a six in Central Italy in multiple years' time, over 5 years. The last large six up in North Italy is when all their scientists were arrested. You remember this? When the Italian geologists were arrested for not warning the people? Well, there was a two-day warning issued on YouTube. I put it on YouTube, okay? So I put it there not because I want to get popular, but because I want people to get the warning so they can prepare. They can know to be watching out for it. If it's going to strike in the middle of the night, people need to be prepared. And to be prepared, you have to know what's going on. Now, as I'm talking, you'll hear booms and rumbles. This is the Earthquake 3D app letting us know more earthquakes are striking this spot. Now, this many aftershocks off of 6, we wouldn't normally expect to see this large of movement, so we may be looking at a larger earthquake coming in the near term, and I'm going to go into that in depth in just a minute. But first, we have to get into what else has struck around the planet today, because this isn't the only significant earthquake. Today is August 23rd. Does that ring a bell for anyone? The date, August 23rd? If you're into seismology, it might ring a bell. You might remember August 23rd, 2011. In 2011, Western Virginia, over here on the east coast of the United States, was struck by a 5.9, 5.8 earthquake near a fracking operation. Now, on that same day, August 23rd, 2011, we saw South Colorado get hit by a large earthquake. Well, ironically, today, August 23rd, South Colorado was hit by a 4.5, now downgraded to 3.9. We had to pressure the USGS to put that information up, by the way, on the magnitudes related to this earthquake, in case you guys didn't see that. So, down to the day, in 2011, August 23rd, there was a 5.4 in Colorado. Now, today, there was a 4.5. In 2011, a 6.0 struck over here in North Italy. Now, here again in 2016. Now, I'm not saying we're on a 5-year cycle. I'm saying that's a very strange coincidence. Also, in addition to all that activity, over here in the West Pacific, a deep 6.0, 6.1 occurred. The deep earthquakes are something we have to especially pay attention to around the entire planet. If you're in Europe, or if you're in the US, or Central America, or South America, here's why. Deep earthquakes cause shallow, larger earthquakes up to 1,000 kilometers away, or up to 1,000 miles as well, I would say. And then that can cause shallow lateral movement around the plates. And so a large earthquake in the West Pacific can cause movement for us over here in the East Pacific, Central America, North America, and South America. So this deep six happening at about 580 kilometers, over 300 miles depth, that's happening down below the plate. It's happening in an area called the asthenosphere, which is just a complex term created by geologists to describe the semi-melted magma down below the plates. So a deep earthquake signifies that there's pressure coming up from down below in the Earth's mantle near the Earth's core. And you have to understand that there's changing theory on the Earth's core of what it's made of, that it's not solid, that the Earth's core is actually plasma energy, and it's expanding right now. It's pushing up pressure from down below, causing deep earthquakes. These deep earthquakes then, as I said, cause shallow, larger earthquakes. Well, if it gets larger, how much larger does it get? As we've seen in the past, usually 1 to 2 magnitudes larger strike nearby the deep earthquakes, whether they're 4s, 5s, or 6s. Once we get above the 6 threshold, I've seen deep 7s and deep 8s occur with no follow-up movement. So maybe there's a size threshold on these deep earthquakes, but I can tell you, when we see deep sixes, we normally see shallow, larger movement nearby within a short amount of time, up to 2 days later. So, this deep six struck today, meaning we have to watch nearby areas, silent zones nearby here, for possible larger movement. Also, in addition, we have to watch for volcanic eruptions to occur now, in South Indonesia in particular. Now, there were several volcanoes that erupted over the past several months, and those most likely will simultaneously, over the next few days going into this week, pop off one by one or multiples at a time in Indonesia. And watch for it, because it's going to occur. That upwelling pressure always causes shallower, larger earthquakes and volcanic eruptions in volcanically prone areas. So that's a lot of activity to talk about. United States struck by a very rare 4.5 at the fracking operations in Colorado. And then, of course, over here in Italy, struck over and over again over the past hours since it occurred. And I think it's been over 2 hours since it occurred. But I would just like to drive home this point about earthquake forecasting. that the way we forecast earthquakes, I've revealed fully, it's no secret. I've done multiple videos explaining how to forecast an earthquake. Put it out on YouTube, a full explanation video on how to do this. And it's very simple, it's Newtonian physics. We're talking about fulcrum points, pressure transferring across solid material. It's pretty basic. And we can know time frames and magnitudes to watch for, and I'd like to get into that now. What are we watching for now that this large earthquake occurred in Europe? What are we watching for now that this deep earthquake occurred in the West Pacific? And what are we watching for in the U.S. now that we've seen this fracking operation get hit? Well, to show you all that, let me go ahead and open up a copy of Google Earth. And let me just make sure you guys can see this all on the screen. And let me make sure you can hear me, since we've had problems over the past several weeks. When we're trying to show something important, it seems the stream dies. But we won't go into that here. So here's the 3.9, 4.5. USGS downgraded that by 5 times to protect the oil companies, and we got into a huge argument today, intellectually, with the USGS. My viewers corrected the USGS, and they corrected themselves after we corrected them on the origins. And you may be able to go see the magnitude page now. Now contains the details and the magnitudes associated with each station, and they added about 100 stations. So somebody got the message through to add the magnitudes, and they did. Now they were hiding them. Why? Why were they hiding the magnitudes? Well, let's pull the coordinates and show you. International viewers, listen up, because up in North Italy, they have the same thing going on that I'm getting ready to show you right here. Which, by the way, the 6.0 earthquake in 2011 in Italy, maybe it was 2012, was at a oil pumping operation, a fracking operation that they have there in Italy. But here we are. You see all these pads? All these different pads? Well, I've got place marks at some of them, but I got tired of doing it because there's a couple thousand wells out here. And when you zoom in on the area, you'll see multiple pads cleared out. Those aren't storage sheds, guys. Each one is a oil well, frack well. And Colorado recently made it a rule that they have to build these little sheds over the fracking operation if they're doing wastewater disposal. But here's an oil well. You can just see the outline of the shadow on that. And there's so many. I mean, they're all over the place here. And what's going on is that they've drilled down into the crust, obviously. And they fractured the area with thousands of wells. Now, what happens is pressure transfers from the west coast of the United States all the way over to the east coast, as given away by the earthquakes on the map now. This is just the last day and a half. Let's look at the last 7 days. Okay, take a look at it. Heavy movement on the west coast, moderate movement in the Midwest, light movement on the east coast. It fans from the west to the east. And it doesn't just happen there. It happens in Central America. And these are color-coded by red being the oldest, white being the youngest. So you can see this past week, several fours striking off the coast of Central America, then multiple other smaller earthquakes striking over to the east. Leftover pressure, pressuring over to the east. Now in the United States, it follows the edge of the interior edge of the craton, which is, a geological term just to describe the plate. So the interior edge of the plate begins up in North Idaho, up northwest of Yellowstone supervolcano, and then it goes down through Wyoming, right across where Yellowstone is, down through Colorado, where the 3.9 is, and then let me turn down the rings so you can see this a little bit better. See the yellow versus green on here? This defines, elevation-wise, the edge of the craton. This is about a 100-mile stretch here, rises 1,000 feet all throughout here. And it goes up into Oklahoma, bends over to the east, and you can make out the bend down here in the south. And fracking operations exist all along this edge. The yellow and green edge, fracking operations the entire way. And I'm not exaggerating. You guys can start in Texas, down at Fort Stockton, go across Texas, up through Oklahoma. You will see just thousands of frack wells marked. And I mean, where I have these yellow place marks are just a few. And then we go up to the north. See this? This takes us into Oklahoma. I don't even have to have states turned on. I can tell by the fracking operations. Then we go over to the east. We have more in Arkansas, but they're all across here. I got tired of marking them, like I said. Then we get down here into Alabama. I mean, guys, down in Tuscaloosa, Alabama, huge fracking operation. Then we go up the east coast and throughout Virginia, West Virginia, Pennsylvania, New York, all of them doing the fracking, and they all get hit by small earthquakes. Whether they get reported or not is a whole nother story. So what's going to go down this week? Well, first of all, you have to look internationally. Like I said, people on the West Coast, you have to watch what's going on in the West Pacific. I know. It's a lot to do because, I mean, how are you going to stay up to date on seismic information? But you have to look at the earthquakes because that will determine what's going to happen over here in our neck of the woods within a couple days. So first things first, we should see shallower, larger movement. Now, it could be a swarm of fives and sixes. We hope for that as opposed to one single larger seven or eight. Like I said, 1 to 2 magnitudes larger off the 6.0. So that takes us 7 to 8.0 again in this area, but we could see swarms release, which is what we hope for. So if a swarm releases, that will then fan out across the whole West Pacific. You'll see fives go from Fiji all the way up to Japan and Kamchatka, Russia, up at the North Pole. But then we'll see here on the west coast of the U.S. within 2 days' time from now that we'll see a combined total of whatever pressure is transferred over, plus the warning signs are already here. We're going to be seeing a mid-4 off the coast of the northwest U.S. here in just a little bit in the next 1-2 days, possibly. Now, if it strikes on land, this is the gamble we have to take like over in Italy. Do you want to take the chance of whether or not that mid-4 to 5.0 earthquake is going to strike out to sea and not cause any damage, or on land? Right here, Eureka, California, Gorda Escarpment going up to the cleft segment, which is here at the Juan de Fuca fracture zone. So that's a small spot to watch. Why are we watching for that? Well, let's just show you the smaller earthquakes that struck today. This will drive home the point. I'm not going to bother looking every earthquake up. I'll just tell you where they are. You guys can go pull the coordinates. Okay, you see a few stacks of earthquakes here, right? These are all smaller earthquakes, but tremendous stack of earthquakes. Where is that occurring? Well, there's so many, I have to turn the rings down and zoom it in. Then you'll see this swarm of earthquakes in particular is happening at Mammoth Mountain Volcano in Eastern California. It's part of the Mono Lake Supervolcanic Field. And longtime viewers, you guys have seen it 1,000 times. If that was the only location that was swarming, you might just say, okay, it's just a random small volcanic swarm, all right. But the other locations in question, every single one of these earthquakes, every single one, is happening at a dormant volcano, including all the way up to Lassen Peak, Lassen Volcanic Field. That's here at the California-Nevada border. I've shown it in every video for the last 2 weeks. So if you want to see the volcanoes, just jump over to my channel and watch a video from a day ago where I took 40 minutes showing all the volcanoes. But now we also see the nuclear operation being hit again. This is a new addition in the past couple days, and this always gets hit right before the pressure releases off the coast. What's going on right here? Why are all these earthquakes striking at volcanoes right now over at the California border going over into Nevada? Upwelling pressure is coming from down below. Like I said, West Pacific upwelling pressure from the core of the Earth. That plays into us over here. And the spot that hasn't moved, the silent zone, just like over in Italy, the silent zone, hasn't moved yet. Building pressure there will release there, and all the warning signs that give away beforehand that there's pressure are showing up right now. So that's all the volcanoes being hit down the coast. You know what? Maybe I should just, let's just go show you one. Why not? Why not? New viewers need to see this. Okay, so you see all these red triangles? These are Smithsonian-marked volcanoes. Now, Mammoth Mountain is a ski resort. But if you look on the screen, you'll see this red cone in the middle there. It's part of a large volcanic field on the Long Valley Caldera. And this connects to Mono Lake Supervolcano. This is Mono Lake up to the north. Hopefully you guys can see all this, right? You can, good. So it's pretty obvious Mono Lake blasted out in the past at some point, and this is connected by a valley right here that goes all the way down to the south, which is connected to more volcanoes. Volcano Peak, for instance, and yesterday, the swarm inside the crater of this ancient volcano that hasn't erupted is called Red Hill. But you can see the crater there. It's an old volcano from probably well over 1 million years ago. Time dating on these, we're going with the USGS dates. But regardless, it's ancient, hasn't erupted in a very long time, and they're all being hit. Now, down to the south, you'll say, Dutch, there's some earthquakes down to the south you haven't mentioned yet. Well, I've been talking about this spot for 2 months. This started with a 5.2 in Southern California, Salton Sea Volcanic Buttes. Then a swarm developed out around the whole area, right around the magma chamber. The magma chamber at about 15 kilometers down below the surface, and that's where the earthquakes are striking. Then the earthquakes spread upwards and outwards over the past 2 months. Now you see a large cluster of earthquakes all the way around Salton Sea, as opposed to just the one spot. Now we're talking about multiple spots. What does this mean? Well, the magma chamber is being displaced. There is no doubt about it. I will venture my whole reputation online on this, that this magma chamber here is being displaced, and we will see a new volcanic butte at some point form, probably in the near term, unless it just dies. If it dies, I'll stand corrected. But if it's too much movement, 5,000 earthquakes over the last 2-3 months, right here, and it's a Smithsonian-marked volcano where they're injecting water down into the volcano to power steam turbines. Well, the magma chamber is right here. The earthquakes are in the shape of the magma chamber, happening at the depth of the magma chamber up towards the surface. And as Salton Sea formed, which you can't even really see here, they've mined out, but the Mexico version of this, just south of the border right here, Cerro Prieto, has not been mined out, leveled, and you can see, okay, same thing. It's a volcano, there's graffiti on the inside of the crater, I've shown it a bunch of times, and it's the same thing. What we get is we have magma chambers down below here that when there's upwelling pressure coming from down below, it causes the magma chamber to go upwards and it finds weak spots and it comes out in multiple little small cones. And that's how we get our multiple buttes out here in the backcountry. And I mean, all throughout east of Los Angeles, you've got hundreds of them, thousands of them, I think, even. These aren't military explosion sites, guys. Each one is a volcanic butte that the same process occurred here. All right? So, all that being said, California being hit, why is it being hit? Upwelling pressure from down below. Now, you'll notice there's a few spots I haven't mentioned yet, and those are right along the coast. Well, just south of San Francisco and in Los Angeles proper. Well, I'm not going to waste your time here because they're just 1.0 earthquakes. As I said, it's just upwelling pressure coming from down below. Each one of these striking near a pumping operation in Los Angeles itself. You guys are welcome to go look it up. They have huge oil pumping operations right around these residential areas in LA, and they're being struck, but just small 1.0 earthquakes. So we have the nuclear operations being struck over here. You guys want to see that? Anybody want to see the nuke ops? Here, let's go ahead and show you. Okay, why not? All right, we'll just drive this home. And the reason the nuclear operations are being hit, where they did the previous underground nuclear test, is because there's fractures that man has made over time. Here, let's back this out a little bit. Range 61 volcanic buttes, Rayson volcanic buttes, and you see all these craters here? Every one of these different craters is a underground nuclear test, and the Google Earth community has actually done, a pretty good job of marking each one. Let's turn those on so you can see exactly how many there are. And you can move your mouse over each one, and they have a name for each nuclear test that occurred. And there's so many here, and the fractures that exist in the crust from that have to extend out for miles. And this is the spot being hit by earthquakes now. And pardon me, guys, I've got a cat here in the room with me. But that all being said, let's get back over to Earthquake 3D one more time. Now you understand. So magma chambers being hit first, they're far down below in the crust. Then upwelling pressure comes up, it hits the nuclear operations with cracks in the crust, and it hits the shallow pumping operations. The only other location I haven't mentioned yet is the swarm to the north, and that's at Clear Lake Volcano. The stack of earthquakes here, the 0.9 and subsequent 2.1s, and that's where they're also injecting water into a volcano to power steam turbines. It's an ancient volcano, it's huge, Smithsonian marked, everybody knows about it, but they're all being struck by earthquakes right now, a sign that pressure is building off the coast of the U.S. So that's the U.S. update. Now, let's get into international. Really quick, we can go over international, we can cover Europe, we can cover Central America, South America. I know a lot of people are curious, you may not live there, but you want to know where else is a large earthquake going to strike. Well, to do that, to determine the spots, we look at the last 48 hours of movement internationally. And I'm using a combined USGS and EMSC feed so that we can see a better picture of what's going down. Now, here in Central America, you'll notice all of Mexico, all of Central America has been quiet for 2 days. Let's turn down for 3 days. One single 4.9 at South Mexico going into Guatemala. That's it. So 48 hours, nothing. And that's not good. We don't like to see silence when it comes to seismic activity. We want to see smaller swarms of earthquakes develop out and relieve the pressure. So, just like all the other areas, just like Italy, just like the United States, we look to the middle of the silent zone for the movement to occur, and we look for a combined total of everything to the north and to the south. Well, and I mean combined total, so you have to add in the fours and threes and twos to the south and the fours and threes and twos to the north over the past few days. Again, take a look at it. Here's the last week, right? So again, when we add in the fours to the south and the fours and threes to the north, and I'm calling it a four. They can downgrade it all they want. They're doing that to protect the oil companies. That was a 4.5 or more. So fours to the north, fours to the south, that puts us into the upper four, lower five range. And if it strikes on land, just like in these other areas, when we get into the five range, it's enough to actually cause damage, hurt people, and possibly even cause a structure collapse in a spot where they're not, you know, building to code like we would build in the United States on the West Coast. So, middle of that zone. Where is it? Well, you have to follow the actual fault zones. Okay, and that's taken us right down into, again, the same spot that was hit 3 days ago. And that puts us right back down in here into Guatemala, possibly as far north as South Mexico. It's a very small little stretch right in here. And we're, again, looking for that combined total between the two. South America, we have a silent zone across now what it looks like Ecuador, where the 3.9 is here. South Ecuador, across Peru, going into North Chile. All the other areas have been hit, including the south tip of Chile, as we warned 2 days ago, meaning Central Peru. Watch Central Peru, combined total between the earthquakes here, and one other thing we have to take into account with South America, the deep earthquake over here. If it causes a shallow, larger earthquake, then you'll see, anytime we see a 7 over here, we see a 7 over here in South America within a few days' time, like we saw this past week. See this? See the 7.2 down here in the South Sandwich Islands? 7.4. Well, you have to imagine on the map here a 7.6 that was downgraded to 7.2 that struck right here in the Solomon Islands near Fiji. Now, that was followed by a 7.4 over to the east within a few days' time, within a week. And it'll happen again. So, South America, the reason this happens, let me quickly explain and get on to the rest of the planet. When the pressure comes from over in the West Pacific, when we see a shallow, large earthquake over here, it transfers across these fault zones. Do you see this? You see these lateral east and west cracks in the crust across the Pacific Ocean? Well, the pressure transfers across these regions. Surprise, surprise. Contrary to what geologists say. And when it hits South America, it hits it like a wall. The pressure has nowhere to go. It hits it like a wall, and it tries to go around the wall and underneath the wall because it can't go over. And when it goes around the wall, it travels, the pressure transfers down the coast of Chile and goes around the bend and strikes down here at the South Sandwich Islands. And we've seen it happen so many times, we're able to make accurate forecasts on it. So there's a middle zone here, the silent zones that get hit, and they've been now hit. All right, so the pressure finds its way always towards the Atlantic, whether it's in the United States, whether it's in Central America, or whether it's in South America. Now over in Europe, let's get into Europe. What do we watch for over here now that we've named out the West Pacific and our spots to watch? Myanmar was struck yesterday, as expected. Now there's a silent zone in between Myanmar and North India going into Kazakhstan. Turkmenistan, Kazakhstan, Tajikistan. All right, so right across in here, there's a silent zone. And where is that? Well, what country is that right there, guys? That's Nepal. We go into Western China, North Nepal, and we have to watch for a combined total between the two sides here. Well, if we have a 5 here and a cluster of 4s here, 10 4s equals 1.5 anyways. So let's call it 2.5s. Well, that takes us into that mid-5 range. And if it strikes in Nepal, people there will freak. So Just let them know, watch out for a mid-5. The reason we're watching for it is the combined total between both sides, which have already moved. The fulcrum in between is the spot which will move next. Now, over here in Europe, the reason the 6 struck, the reason all this occurred, we have to go back again. Let me turn on the last 30-day feed from the USGS. This is really going to show you guys. Okay, so this is the last 30 days, and I'm turning it down now. Let's just put it for the last week and a half, 2 weeks. Here's 2 weeks. There's 2 weeks. All right, so heavy movement over the last 2 weeks over here in the West Pacific, including that 7 that I was talking about. Now let's turn off the 4s and only look at the 5s. Okay, 5s. This is now 5s over the last 2 weeks. And you see the several deep earthquakes, they're raised high off the globe, and the shallow, larger movement that spread out from those deep earthquakes are pretty obvious, okay? So when we take a look here and you see the 5s that pressed across Myanmar, over here towards China, Western China, South Russia, and Kazakhstan, Tajikistan, that then terminated here and built and built and built. And what happened over the past 2 weeks was all those 2s and 3s all throughout here, and that exists throughout Turkey, South Greece, Western Iran, South Russia. I guess that's Georgia. Black Sea is right here. Caspian Sea is right there, okay? So this spot here kept swarming and swarming and swarming. And you go back 2 weeks, go back 1 week, you'll hear me mentioning it over and over again. There's something building down here. It's going to press to the west-northwest. Now, why does it press to the west-northwest? Just like I explained over in the United States, and let's look at the last week's worth of earthquakes again really quick, just so we can show that to you. United States, pressure transfer from west coast to east coast, all right? Now, over in Europe, pressure transfers from the Mideast over towards the Atlantic, and it goes across Europe. So what do we watch for next? Now that there's been multiple 6s, multiple 4s, and 5s striking throughout Italy, there's 2 things that we need to watch for. 1, adjacent lateral movement nearby, in a nearby silent zone. The prone zone that appears to have been developing over the past several weeks and months goes down here towards Gibraltar and then cuts over across the Azores out to the North Mid-Atlantic Ridge. Additionally, we see pressure transfer across Central Europe and go out towards the Mid-Atlantic, up towards Iceland. Well, this puts the English Channel back into the mix. This puts Poland back into the mix. North Europe, it puts you back into the mix. About 1,000 kilometers away, we have to watch for movement. There's been some deep earthquakes, very large earthquakes here, and we have a silent zone that's developed between the 6 in Italy and the 4.5 up south of Svalbard. That's where the 4.5 is there. So, go between those 2 points, and it kind of bends with the curvature of the Earth, and that then puts North England or the English Channel, North France back into the mix, and we have to watch for leftovers off this, not larger, but leftovers. So this is relieving a lot of the pressure there. It's obvious. You can see the stack of earthquakes that's going on there. So watch the area to the west-northwest. Should be some lateral movement, and it should happen in the next few days. My European viewers, look, I've got people in Netherlands, I got people in Belgium, we've got people in UK, we've got people in Denmark, we've got people all over North Europe, Norway. You can be prepared, and you might need to watch for it magnitude-wise. Now, the leftovers off this, I would be more leaning towards just that 3.0-ish activity to spread out to the north. Now, could go a little larger. Could go, I was 1 magnitude off on this Italy earthquake. If I'm 1 magnitude off in North Europe, a 4 is enough to definitely cause damage to your stone structures. Since you have old brick and stone mortar, you have old, even older, that's not really earthquake proof. So you can take precautions now. You can look into insurance options. You can take those things into account. The silent zones are our enemies when it comes to seismic pressure. You want to see smaller earthquakes relieving that pressure, even across the English Channel. And if there's not even a 1 that's been striking there recently, and it was struck by 4s last year, well, you have a 6 to your south now. Pressure transfers to the west-northwest. One more time, if you're just now tuning in, let me go ahead and bring us back over to the live stream now that we've done our international update. It looks like there's about a fair amount of people in here right now, about 700 people. This earthquake in Italy was forecast to occur. I was one magnitude off, actually a magnitude and a half off. I was only looking for a mid 4 to 5.0 earthquake to strike. The reason a larger earthquake struck is most likely due to the other deep earthquakes that struck over the past day, 2 days, over in the West Pacific. You almost have to go back and watch my update, which was made 2 days ago. It's on my YouTube channel. It's titled West Coast in Japan Earthquake Watch. And at the end of the video, about 38 minutes into the video, I fully address Europe and address why we're watching Italy. Over the next day, we'll have to really keep a close eye on the swarm in Italy itself. Why? Well, with this amount of fours and fives striking afterwards, you wouldn't normally expect to see a six cause a bunch of subsequent fives. That's slightly abnormal. What does it mean? Well, it means there's a lot of pressure being released there. I'm not shocked because of the amount of time we didn't see any larger movement in South Europe. Like I said, it's been like a week and a half, 2 weeks of just these building twos and threes down to the south. Finally, it's like a pinball game. You pull back the spring and finally it let go and it hit at that spot. Now it's going to press to the west-northwest. So I guess the good news for Italy is that unless something further develops, the only thing you might want to watch out additionally for, and people in Italy are already aware of this, the volcanoes in South Italy, let's say Mount Etna, you might see some new impressive blasts at some of your, and volcano, they have a volcano called Volcano. Well, watch those two volcanoes, and you'll have to, you know, keep an eye on those on the webcams. It probably wouldn't cause very much damage if a big eruption did occur, because Mount Etna erupts every single month of every single year for the past God knows how long. So people in Italy, listen up. There was a 2-day warning issued. Do this for science. I'm not asking for personal credit. I'm just asking you guys to at least hear me out and share the warnings when I put them out. I'm not issuing warnings lightly. If I issue a warning for an area, I explain why. I don't just say, watch Italy. I say, watch Italy. Here's why. Here's where. Here's what we're watching for. And if I'm wrong, I'll issue a correction. Well, the location was spot on, and I'm one magnitude off. So that all being said, I'm not patting myself on the back. People got hurt, guys. I don't know if people got killed or not. Either they got hurt or killed. Either or. It's terrible. They had a 2-day warning. The only reason they didn't get it is because of politics and censorship. Censorship. And I mean shutting down the earthquake forecast. You have to understand, the USGS and the Pacific Northwest Seismic Network took to CBS News to smear me. They issued horrible press releases about me, guys. The USGS and the Pacific Northwest Seismic Network, with their lead geologist, this guy, he's a field medal recipient from the American Geophysical Union, and they came over and disparaged me horribly. Personally, it wasn't even about science. They accused me of being a terror promoter or horror promoter or something. I mean, it was just insane. And they denied that earthquakes could be forecast. Well, they jailed geologists in Italy. Now, they're free, thank God. You shouldn't jail scientists for being wrong. But they jailed geologists for not accurately warning the public when the last large earthquake struck. I don't want to hear any excuses this time. There was a 2-day warning publicly issued on YouTube for everyone to review. And whether or not people review, it's because you don't know. Do you know? Did most of you know, the new people in here, know that there's somebody on YouTube that's forecasting earthquakes and trying to warn the world when large earthquakes are coming, and even smaller earthquakes, like I said, fours on the West Coast? They really did destroy me in the news for trying to do this, guys. So I rely on you to share it out and to put it back to them. Because now people are dead or hurt, and they didn't get a warning because of politics and censorship. And I won't stand for that. Today, science wins. Finally. We're not going to stand for anything less than the people of Italy being told they had a 2-day warning. And I'd be happy to teach any Italian scientist the method I've already put out the documentation on how to do it yourself, the posts, written down, and made a video. It's creatively called How to Forecast an Earthquake by dutchsinse. Okay? So there is no doubt about it. If anybody wants to know how to forecast an earthquake, I've made that information publicly available, and I show it in every single video, including the video issued 2 days ago. I went into full explanation why we were watching East Italy, east of Rome. That's very specific, right? I mean, it's not like just waving a magic wand over an area and picking something. It is determined by the silent zones, and the fulcrum point in the middle of that zone. Basic Newtonian physics applied to plate tectonics. It's amazing. It defies all of geology. They're going to have to correct themselves and issue public apologies to me for what they did. But at this point, it's not about me. Now anybody can do this. I will teach Italian scientists how to do it. They can just take it from there. They don't even have to give me credit. I'll do it behind closed doors. We can meet, if you're an Italian scientist, we can meet behind closed doors. And I will teach you. You never have to say you met with me, and I will never mention your name to anybody except my wife. All right? And my mom. Maybe Tad. All right, guys, much love. I'm done with the update. If anything else goes down, I will be on here. I want to thank everybody for being part of this. Please bookmark my page. Please subscribe if you're not subscribed. It's how I grow on YouTube. I don't make any money from subscribers, but it's just, you know, it helps me grow and it makes me look good on YouTube if you guys subscribe. So please get the word out. It's about saving lives at this point. The professionals are in denial. Why are they in denial? Well, they wrote down on their websites and in books that it was impossible to forecast earthquakes because it was too complex. And now that they've written that down, the USGS has something on their website saying that. Now that they've gone on the record and said that, it's kind of like professional egg on face. But now people died. So are we going to, you know, at the USGS, Professor John 𓵒𝓲𝓿𝒆 from the Pacific Northwest Seismic Network, who disparaged me on CBS News, at some point, you guys got to wise up because people's lives are depending on you. I'm a YouTuber. I'm a guy. I'm a guy here in St. Louis who figured something out that I wish I would have never discovered, quite frankly. But because I discovered it, and I know it's right, I'm not going to back down. Science wins on this. And ironically, today of all days, with the August 23rd and the fracking earthquakes hitting the United States, today is the day that we get even for all the stuff that was done. Much love, everybody. I want to thank you. I'll be back. I'll put some music back on. If anything goes down, like I said, I'm here all night. I'll be here at a moment's notice if another large earthquake strikes. Much love.